What do you want? Leave us alone.
What's up?
Hey.
Hello.
How's it going?
Oh, I'm going, dude.
Hello, world.
That's right. You dealing with me tonight.
Woo! Cool.
I like that we both have a white piece of paper in front of us.
Blank piece of paper, I know.
That means it's going to be a good show.
Wasn't ready for it. Yeah, it's like everything is always not within reach. I need a piece of tape. I don't know what happened. Anyway, yeah, it's welcome to the Yardcast, everybody. Gonna drop for a couple hours, gonna do some comics. Concerned is already here, says let's do this. Drippin's here, says it's on.
I took that as a threat.
Cool. What you gonna draw tonight?
I'm not sure yet. Probably a skull because I can whip those out. You know, I'll feel comfortable on camera doing one with a blank piece of paper.
Nice. I have a commission to do of a girl, but I'm kind of like, I don't know. I haven't quite got an idea in my head yet, so I might do something different. Do something for eBay real quick or something. It's like this guy's character.
Oh, somebody, another she's character?
Like, dang, she's like a
lot of people's characters lately.
A tiger chick, yeah.
Pretty cool.
yeah.
Yeah, that's different, man.
Yeah, a little bit. It's like his comic book kind of character, I think, or something.
I'm saying that's the second one you've kind of done, though. You did Critical Snell, now this one.
Yeah, that's true.
Do you usually get a lot of stuff like that?
Not so much. No, really. I guess not. I mean, I get people's projects like that, you know, like the Honey People or whatever that was called, the Honey World podcast or whatever. I've got to like tweak those guys' logo. I knew that was going to happen though. I finally got that thing done and now they're kind of like wanting me to tweak the type and all that crap, all that, you know, people just go over and over it forever with. But anyway. Mm-hmm. That's neither here nor there.
That's my problem.
So,
focus there. Put this whole camera in focus. Yeah, I think I'll draw a little skull. Still feeling a little under the weather. Still not 100% for sure.
Really?
But you know how it is. You just got to start ignoring it after a while.
Yeah.
Time to start moving on. See what happens.
That's right.
I did get that test.
Did she?
Now it's 2 days to wait for an answer.
Oh, God. Yeah, it's like, talk about forever. Yeah. It's like, what the hell?
Sweating, I mean, I don't know. Man. I mean, I don't, doesn't matter if I do or don't. By this point in time, I'm almost done being sick, you know? but I've been sweating so much. A lot of sweating, dude. Whatever I got right now, man.
I'm just
like sweating a lot. It's like, should be working out. Man. Get that COVID body.
Get that COVID body.
Get that COVID body, man. Let's see that, man. Think about it.
Yeah.
How is it? We've all been on lockdown in the States now for, 6-7 months?
Yeah.
It's like, all y'all bastards are getting fatter instead of getting muscled up. Y'all have been working out this whole time, and you come out of COVID all ripped. Like a superhero. Should have
been treating it like prison.
Hell yeah.
Big model.
Like prison. Don't go all the way. Just a little bit. Speaking of prison, man, I heard Little Reva's got a single coming out, man. Supposed to drop on midnight tonight.
When those blank sheets of paper create artist block. Yeah, I know.
Draw something on it real quick.
I've heard Little Reva. I wonder if anybody knows. You get the reference that they watched the show last night, though.
I don't know.
Little Kill Reaver. That's what we're talking about.
Sorry. That's forever now. That's going to be part of the show forever. If y'all don't know, Kill Reaver funded, guys. And somehow in the middle of that, Randy came up with Lil Reaver, which has now turned into Lil Reva. And
yeah.
Awesomeness. Randy needs to write a book, man. That's the next book. He should have had a stretch goal to where if you hit it, you got like a little ash can of Lil Reva.
Oh God.
You should be in here, Randy.
That's what we all be
writing that shit down. You're welcome. We
all need with our comics is this extra ash can mini comic idea. I think came up with it for almost every.
Somebody else to draw it or something. You can do it. You know what I'm saying?
Somebody else to draw it.
For somebody. That thing's going to get shipped out. So,
does anybody want to draw some Berserker now for me?
You better watch that, dude. Drop it in the chat here. I'd love to draw Berserker now for you. Then you're going to have to be telling people no.
Oh, God. Yeah, that's probably right. Because that's how I am. I am a control freak, and I have a tendency to go like, nobody can do it right except for me.
That's how you go. You say what Jeff does is goes, it's not going to work.
Yeah. That is how I say no. I kind of say yes, and I say nah, never. But hey, that's the way it is, right?
Hey, dude, gotta get it, dude. No is a no. Don't be date raping people.
Date raping?
Oh, hey, don't watch that word.
Oh God. Yeah, I see where you went with that. No means no.
No means no, people. No means no.
Mike Whitcomb is here.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
He's making fun of me. Howdy, guys. Not everybody in Texas says howdy, Mike. How dare you? How dare you?
I say hidey-ho.
There you go. Well, I thought that was something that people in Colorado did. They get on the mountain and go, hidey-ho.
Yeah, yodel.
Sorry.
That's what yawn does. I'm wrong about that. I don't know what to draw. Let's see. Right. I need to sketch something. I am not a good without sketching, and I have no sketchbook. Mm-hmm. So. And this is what's happening to all my fucking notebooks and shit that I sketch in. It's like Tristan's goddamn homework, like everywhere in here. And every now and then I'll sketch a little something, and then it's like just like endless division and shit, you know? Mm-hmm. So.
There you go. You see some
I should have just I should
knock that shit out for us.
You want to learn some long division? Look at this. It's just endless.
There you go.
You filled this whole damn thing up. It's like no pages left.
All right, just keep
I mean, I did actually have a kind of an idea for that. The girl one. Maybe I should just freaking go for it. I don't know.
Go for it, dude.
They always turn out. But then, yeah, that's what I end up doing. I draw something on one side, flip the page over. Finally, when I run out of like alternatives, I'll actually get something down.
Yeah,
how
much? I was just, I started drawing a circle and my hand felt all weak there for a second.
Well, that's weird.
I'm going to draw a little bit.
The COVID's setting in.
That's it, yeah. Nah. I do feel weak, though. For real.
Yeah,
weak and kind of sweaty. That's really about it for me right now, man. It's like I'm weak and sweaty.
Well, are you sweaty because it's hot there or are you sweaty because?
It's like, no, dude, it's not hot. I was sweating so bad. I was like, man, fuck it. I'm gonna turn the AC on just to like kill the, if there is humidity in the house. Well, I said, it's not humid. Now you're making it cold. I'm like, well, deal with it.
Oh man.
Just to kind of kill out the humidity a little bit.
Yeah.
All right. Let's do something here.
like silence.
There you go. Well, yeah, because you got to get a couple lines. Everybody, that's the problem with this. It's like you got to shut up and think about something for 5 seconds.
Very true.
So, what are you doing this in? Is this a color piece, or is this going to be a airbrush like you've been doing them, or black and white?
Like this thing I'm going to do right this very second. The commission is black and white. Huh? Yeah, the commission piece is like black and white.
Black and white.
Yeah. So it's kind of like those other ones I was doing before I left my house or whatever.
Yeah, man. Chipping away at that commission list, though.
Yeah, I am. Let's see what I'm down to. I marked everybody off. Can I make another one? I don't have one up here. I don't have no mark button. Oh, here we go. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Get the mark another one off.
That's it.
Let's see.
Don't lie. I can count those from here.
3, 4, 5. Wait, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I only got 5 left, which that's getting down to where I can maybe start blowing some off. Oh, but that's the other, I don't have the other one on here. So I should actually write him on there. So I have 6 right now.
Don't forget about him. You got 6? That ain't bad. You're not in double digits at least.
Yeah, I'm below 10 finally, so that's nice. And one of them's kind of easy. I don't know though. And I got one that's brutally hard that I don't even want to think about. So that one seems to never go away. And then I got one that I actually didn't take, which I might just ditch this guy because I didn't take his money. So I might just be like, you know what, I don't want to do it.
And now you know.
Always give me money. No, they don't. I don't think anybody who gets commissions from me even watches the show. You know what I mean? In general, except for maybe Pixel Trader, because he was here yesterday. But it seems like other people just, I don't know.
Those other people, they're out to get Berserkanaut in demand on Indiegogo.
Yeah,
I keep it right there on my side table now, Jeff.
That's cool. I have Baby Rocket on my side table right here. Oh. I'd like to have Doom Barbarian. I'd like to do a Doom Barbarian piece. Maybe I'll do that right now. What do you think?
Okay. That's up to you, man. I'm not going to pressure you into anything. I have my hopes up. Jeff's got to make some money. I think sitting in the back burner for 12 years.
I just do it and finish it tonight.
No, that's not how you're going to do it, Jeff. I mean, I'm going to dictate the whole thing now.
I told Randy I'd do a Kill Reaver thing for him,
you should do a Kill Reaver while the campaign's going.
I started looking at that damn helmet and I was like, oh, God. so detailed. Yeah, we did just
going, Randy.
Throw in the are people who want commissions even aware you do this show, Jeff? I know it's kind of weird that like I think a lot of them just they don't seem to even register, you know. I don't know where like when I share the show out they how they find me or whatever, but then it's just like they just, or maybe it's because it's 2 hours so they start to watch and they're like I can't do this for 2 hours. But I don't remember what his name was, but he said that one of his first breaks was working on the Archie comic books.
Read the next one. It'll make more sense.
Hey, guys. It was cool the other night. I was listening to Coast to Coast AM, and the guest was a guy who is a cartoonist, and he began on the golden era of comic books. Golden era. And he worked on Archie? And he was, I wonder what was his paranormal experience or whatever, you know, like, Because that's like, that's what that show is, right? That's like the old Art Bell show right there, Coast to Coast.
I can just Art Bell Coast to Coast.
I don't know what to draw. Yeah, I love that show. I don't know. Then I got to do something good. You know what I mean?
You don't have to draw him good.
Well, you'd want him good, though. Why didn't you put, like, a better picture of on him on Indiegogo? You got, like, this little tiny thing. I need, like, a really... Well, I mean, it's like a... It's pretty good. Well, no, you put the whole video. It looks good, but... Now that your Indiegogo is done, it's, like, grayed out. I can't see it no more.
Oh, so. You can't see all the big... All the other... I was going to say, man, I thought I had a ton of pictures of stuff in that on that thing. I, like, listed five pictures of... You know, it's also on Webtoons, Jeff. You know? The whole book. Almost the whole book. The last stuff I never put up.
I don't know.
He's easy to draw, man. He's basically a mix between Mitor and the Glenn Danzig skull.
Yeah. We see that. The thing is like I barely knew who Glenn Danzig was anyway before you start talking about him every night. So like that doesn't help me
that much. But no, that skull comes from a comic book. I can't remember the name of it. I'll look it up real quick.
Did you ever put Doom Barbarian on Drunk Talk?
Uh-uh.
Should have done Drunk Talk. That was like the only place that, you know, people would really read the Berserk about as a webcomic, I thought. They have like an adult morning when I go to like what's it called?
A what?
Your comic on Webtoons. It's like some adult warning. It's like there's adult content if you go forth and all that stuff.
I draw those crude boobies.
Oh, yeah. I forgot you got naked chicks. They're all thing.
It's the Saga of Crystar.
Crystar?
Is where the Danzig skull comes from. Yeah. There it is in the bottom. Very cool.
It says, notice that the left hand is out in the lead here. I should have jinxed you guys with a writer's block comment. Yeah, I know. Yeah,
that's what I was going to draw. And I was like, man, not easy. I'm just going to throw a skull on a piece of paper so I don't have any.
Well, that's my usual thing, though. I scribbled something on this, and then I still have a blank page. So I'll scribble something here, then I'll have to put this over, and then I'll put this one over, and then I'll have to keep going. And then it'll be on. But I don't know if I do Kill Reaver, I should probably do something I could sell or something, put on eBay, you know.
Yeah, there
so.
You go.
I mean, Doom, you know, Doom Barbarian. It's like, I mean, you might buy it, but
no. So you need to be like, somebody that's something that sells. I don't know.
Let's see. Black Widow. Sell Black Widow in your sleep right now. Mandalorian, I'm sure you could sell that. You know, no matter how bad it is. Yeah. Baby Yoda. Sell like a motherfucker right now, I'm sure. Just gotta avoid the Disney cops.
Mickey Mouse gonna come over and arrest you. Gonna rough you up a little bit.
That's probably why you have to throw it on eBay and not on not Etsy, because you might sit around on Etsy too long, they'll come get you.
Come get you.
Yeah, they'll get you with a cease and desist.
That was it. That's how they get you.
And that's that is actually how they get you, as far as I know. That's how they've gotten me.
Until they showed up. And wanted money.
No, either a cease and desist doesn't mean jack shit. You know what it is? It's just a letter from a lawyer that says, "Hey, we're gonna sue you if you don't knock it off." And then the thing, you know, I think most people just ignore it anyway because it's like the internet. Mm-hmm. But you know, like Etsy will take it down or something. So like I, you know, like a few things have been jerked off Etsy over the years for me, like Like, I remember, like, the Hunger Games. Like, I did a Hunger Games commission for somebody, you know, that girl on there. And then, the you know, it was around the time the movie came out. And I put a print up, and then, you know, they jerked it down on Etsy because they got a cease and desist from, you know, whoever. And, you know, it's like, big deal. They're really going to take the time to go sue me for what, like the $12 I make on that print and give me a break. So. And, you know, like I heard on YouTube, which I've never tested this theory, but I've heard that, like, if you get a copyright strike from somebody and you can test it, then, like, what's it? What did they say? They said that eBay gives you like gives the other party like 25 days or something like that, or 2 weeks or some weird number. Yes, 2 weeks is some weird number or something like that. But to you know, sue you or pursue this in court, and then if you don't do it, then they take the strike off and put your thing back up. Which I've never really tested that, but. I've heard it from guys like who've been fighting like on YouTube and stuff, and that's what they said. So I don't know if it would work with like, you know, you swipe something off like the New York Times website or something. But.
Wait, well, you get three strikes like after that? Well, yeah, I think I've heard that too. And then,
well, that's the way it used to be with the three strikes,
and they do hit you on, and then you get like three strikes or whatever, right?
Yeah, the way it used to work was the three strike thing. You get three copyright strikes, and then they take your channel off. It was copyright strikes a long time ago. But then the copyright strikes eventually became something different, and now it's like, I think they call them content strikes, and those are the ones you have to watch out for. Because copyright strikes are like nothing anymore. Like you can get copyright strikes like up the wazoo. Because I get them all the time. Yeah. And
somebody else.
Yeah, they give the option to monetize to like another, you know, the other people. Or let's see, what was I saying? Forgot. Yeah. Or they just they block it. You know what I mean? Like they took down. That one, the great one about Sam Fliegel or whatever that we did.
Lincoln's episode.
Yeah, the devil on it and the midget wrestling, which was so awesome.
It deserved it. If it didn't come down. It would have upset me. That show had to go down. Does that make sense? No, I don't know. Ruined it. It was supposed to be a joke, but it didn't come out right. I got all stuttery. I got all... couldn't get it out.
Yeah.
That's all right. I'll cry later about that.
I can't draw. Yeah, it's like something caught me in the chat, though, actually.
I haven't been looking. I've been drawing, Jeff, not reading the chat. Jesus.
He says, I know, but you were saying whatever that joke was. This is why I totally missed it, because he said, I found a blurb on Coast to Coast AM about the cartoonist comic book artist Neil Adams discusses his career. Maverick Science Theories. Do you guys know who he is?
Neil Adams?
Yeah, Neil Adams. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Neil Adams was like a really famous like Batman artist, and you know, he's like just an overall famous comic book artist. He's kind of older now, he's sort of retired, but he's still like, you know, I could see him going on Coast to Coast and like shooting his mouth off about stuff. He's got a lot of stories if you ever met him in real life. I worked for him, and like way back in the day, he was like my second like professional job or something. And I got hired on, you know, anyway, Neil Adams had a company called Continuity, and he'd start this company up like over and over again, and he'd always go broke. And so anyway, he started this continuity back up, and I sent like submissions in there, and so they just hired me off these submissions, and I got hired as an inker on a book called, and I'm trying to think, but it was like Earth something. I can't remember what the hell that book was called, though. Was it called Earth 4, was it? I can't believe I have to wake up my own shit to remember. But anyway, I wasn't a very good inker. Oh, yeah, it was called Earth 4 from Continuity Comics. And Neil Gaiman was the, or Neil Adams was the, you know, editor-in-chief. And then his wife kind of ran the company. And so, like, his wife was, like, the one I would deal with, like, all the time. And, of course, this is, like, back in the days when you, like, FedEx your stuff and you're working from home and everything. And then you get, like, a telephone call from them to tell you how you're doing. And so, like, she would, like, call me, like, every week about like whatever pages I was doing. But then like I screwed up a couple times. Like I get tired of inking in like one style, so I started like change my style up. And this one time she calls me up and she was like, you gotta talk to Neil. So then like Neil Adams gets on there. Uh-oh. And he like starts complaining to me that my rocks don't look like rocks anymore. I need to get some rock reference because I inked these rocks like too slickly, and they go back to the way I was inking before. It's kind of funny. He did that a few times. That was like the only time I ever would like actually talk to him. That was kind of like when he wanted to complain at me. And I was like a terrible inker. I wasn't a very good inker. I don't know why they hired me. And
were you just, then, you were just in the interiors?
Are you doing the covers? No, I think I did the covers. I can't remember who the artist was on there either.
None of this stuff looks signed.
Are you looking it up?
Numbers? Were you doing early numbers? What numbers? You know?
They were semi-early. I actually have what the first one I pulled up was one that I was on. Let me share my screen. It says Earth 4 number 1, actually.
Beginning.
Let's see here. But I think Earth 4 is that my screen? Okay, that's it. So this one right here was one of them. So that is actually my inking back then, right there. And this purple guy with his head flying off and stuff.
What's wrong with that? You didn't like it?
Well, it's just, you know, I don't know. I didn't go into comics to become an inker, so I just looked at it, you know, I was like...
So you're like, no good. No good, because I don't want to do it.
Here we go. See, he said, did they credit you as Feffery? Probably. That's like something I wouldn't doubt they would do, is like spell my name wrong. But I saw a copy of Earth 4 at the dollar store once. I think that penciler was Ron Garney. That could be. That doesn't sound familiar to me, though. But I think Earth 4, like, was, it kind of, like, would come back every time continuity came back. So, like, we were just sort of, like, the team on this version of Earth 4 at that time, you know? Mm-hmm. And what was I going to say? But, anyway, like, yeah, when the company, like, finally, they went broke again, then they didn't pay us all for, like, the last, you know, whatever, couple weeks that we worked. And then I, like, saw everybody, like, complaining a couple months later in, like, the Comics Journal. Of course, there's no internet back then, so people would write into the Comics Journal and yell at Neil Adams, you did it again to us. You know what I mean? Of course, I didn't realize that, like, continuity had went out of, like, you know, business a bunch of times before that. So I was just, like, happy to get any kind of work, you know. Mm-hmm. There's my story. There it is. My Neil Adams story.
And you had the receipts too to prove it. Showed up with a receipt. Well, he didn't show up with them. He went on Google and said, they're right here.
Here's the receipt. Well, I did. Yeah. I did more than just that one, but I don't know. It was all like, it was just a little short stint of inking that I got until they went out of business. And then I was unemployed for another like year or something, and I don't remember what the next thing I was. I found
me being unemployed. Oh,
huh?
Screw the inking job, man. Being unemployed, that sounds exciting.
Well, I was unemployed in college. I'm sure I had a job or something at the time.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
So what's this helmet like made out of? Like a water buffalo skull or something?
What? On who?
On the Doom Barbarian.
No, I don't know.
Come on. It's water buffalo horns.
If it needs to be, yeah, it kind of looks like water buffalo horns, doesn't it?
I don't know.
I'm telling you, man. I just said, Danzig skull looks cool. And I like Mitor. This is on. There we go. So, I'm going to use these type of horns.
I'm going to look up this Danzig skull.
So I think Mitor's got those type of horns, too.
Oh, I see. He's this guy. Yeah. I don't know what that is.
What do you
goat horn thing or something? You draw them thicker, so to me they look more like water buffalo horns, but yeah. I guess it's kind of like goat horns or something, maybe.
Yeah, I would say if I was gonna name it, say anything or anything, yeah, they'd be like water buffalo horns, sure. Looking for like goat horns or some animal to compare them to, yeah.
Yeah.
That would be the one. That would be the one. All right. Yeah. I think I've drawn too many skulls in my day, man.
That's a great one. I love that skull. It's fantastic. Oh, well, you know that. Oh, Walter McDaniel. Yeah. Somebody put it in there. That was the guy I was inking right there. So,
you but I was him inking your work. You said, I need to be drawing this stuff. You should be inking me. Don't lie. And see, that's the problem. No. Is Jeff wouldn't have wanted that guy to ink him anyway. Jeff,
I think.
No, I want to draw it and pencil and ink it.
Yeah. Well, I always thought that shit, but you know, back in the day, you know, like nobody, or like very few anyway, kind of did that. So,
And that was what I think. I looked at those comics. That was like early '90s. Like, but
it's pretty early. Yeah.
Earlier.
Something like that. Yeah. Well, it was probably, yeah, around there. It was kind of before I ever sort of like feel like I kind of got into comics, you know? Like when I did the Doom 2099 and stuff, that was later. That was a few years later.
I got into comics when I started penciling or when you got to Marvel.
Yeah. I mean, I first it was Malibu, so I felt like the Malibu stuff was like, you know, they were paying me and I was making a living at it. So to me, that was comics. Mm-hmm. So
cool. You're like, I made it, Malibu comics. Get out of my way. next thing, Marvel.
I liked Malibu.
Marvel at DC. Marvel.
Yeah, next thing was Marvel, because that's what happened. Malibu got sold to Marvel, and then that's how I got my little break into comics. Was there was an editor, Susan Gaffney, and she was editing some of the, like, or an assistant editor or something on like some of the X-Men books. They had like a lot of X-Men books at the time, and then she let me do a couple like pinups, and then that turned into the covers, and that turned into Doom 2099 later. It's my big break. Then Hung on the Range was my downfall.
Your downfall. What were your X-Men books? This is the X-Men book I did.
I always feel like I'm like name dropping and shit when like we get into this. But it's like, I did the X-Men. Anyway.
No one's listening. No one's listening.
Come on. There's like hundreds of people out there right now. But yeah, like one of them was a Scotty X-Men. That was like one of them. And Phoenix Resurrection. That was like another miniseries thing.
Phoenix Resurrection.
Yeah, I wasn't ever on like a consistent X-Men book. They were all kind of like mini series and stuff. But yeah, Phoenix Resurrection. That's a lot of people kind of remember that one because like after Jean Grey died, that's like when she came back, you know. So
that's like that's also like, I guess like the movie story, like storyline they like to kind of center around.
I guess so. I remember she got killed.
And Dark Phoenix type stuff.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. Is that what she comes back as? Is the Dark Phoenix?
I think. Is that my
right? That might be right. It's funny. I never was like a huge like Marvel fan, you know. I was like not that much into like what I was doing. So like there's always like the people who ask you like, what's like your favorite Marvel character that you always wanted to draw, or like, and there really wasn't like anything at the time, you know, like Conan was gone, you know, there wasn't any like Tarzan comics or anything like that. And I didn't really have like a ton of interest in the X-Men or a lot of superhero stuff. So maybe like Batman or something would have been really neat to get on, but yeah, I never did that. So I don't know. I just didn't keep up, you know?
Yeah.
With what was going on. I remember they'd send me like big old stacks. Like when I did Doom 2099, they sent me like stacks of like kind of the Doom 2099, because we were like on the very end tail of that. And, you know, for me to catch up on the character and all that shit. Because I was like clueless.
What was crazy is I thought they were like, we were talking a while back and we were like, we'd only come up with like, I think three titles for the Doom or for the 2099 series. It was Doom, Spider-Man, and then there was
right.
one more.
And there's, I can't remember what it was. There was four of them, right?
Yeah, well, yeah, there was another. There was because we came up with another one. But then I was going to say, I was at the Half Price Books the other day and they had another one. And I can't remember who it was now, but it was a character I really didn't hear of before.
Concern says, yeah, it's late. What's the little name dropping?
Huh?
So anyway, yeah, Ravage, I don't, I'm sorry. What was it?
Ravage 2099?
Ravage?
Yeah.
Was that the other one?
But, huh?
Was that the other one?
That's one. Yeah, one of them. Because I found that one in the Half Price Books, and I looked it up to make sure it was the name before. Yeah, said it. Ravage. Yes, Ravage in 2099. I don't even remember this book. So
yeah. Like I know that it was like Spider-Man. It was Doc Doom, and then yeah, I can't even remember. Right? Like what the fuck?
And this Ravage one, and then Punisher.
Oh, Punisher. Okay.
That's what it was.
See, that would have been a neat book to get on. Punisher.
Yeah. And they, oh man, but they, I remember now why I didn't like this. Because his costume is so weak.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Is that when?
Cool now, but
yeah.
The old costume was weak, dude. You'd have been like, come on, let me get rid of all this fucking red BS all over him and give him a cool skull.
Yeah, dude, really.
Weak as hell, bro. Weak.
That's some weak shit right there. That's a weak sauce.
Do you see him? Or do I even share him for you?
Yeah, sure, share. You want? I'm not looking on the internet right now.
All right.
Abe says that Ravage was like the guy who beasted out and grew horns and stuff. So here, I was trying to read.
Oh, little. How do I make that big? I don't even know. They're all little old wimpy pictures.
Come on, Jim. Oh God, I can't even see that. Yeah, I remember that though. That's such a faggy costume.
Oh man, it's
horrible.
They tried to make him like 80s cyberpunk kind of thing, and it just did not work.
Yeah,
did not work. But what is going on in the front of that belt? Can you explain the front of that belt to me? I don't get that.
So bad.
I don't know.
And honestly, Doom 2099, you know, with like the writing on that, in my opinion, was like god awful. It was like the storyline was just, I don't know who the hell was writing at that time, but it just, I don't get it. Yeah, I mean, you got kind of like a tragic, like, villain right there, you know? Mm-hmm. And I don't see why that, why didn't they do that, you know? Why didn't they, like, I don't know, continue that theme on, but it just seemed like, I don't know, whatever, who cares? Mm-hmm. But yeah, I wanted to get back to, like, what they were talking about Neil Adams, because Neil Adams quotes are funny. Interestingly, Neil Adams said that today is the best time in history to be a comics artist. That's pretty wild. That's what Concern says. I wonder why he would say that.
Maybe because of promotion? I don't
know. You could get on the internet and, you know. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of true. But the only thing that I think about that is, like, I really feel like comics is really, like, you know, like, I mean, comics on the stand are, in my opinion, I've come around, you know, it's like, I feel like they're dying away. And it's sort of like the last days, you know. I mean, not in the sense of, like, how Comicsgate says it, and, like, you know, the whole industry is crashing and they're going to somehow save it or something, but, like, I just feel like it's just shrinking because, like, nobody can get comics anywhere. Like, nobody can fucking buy comics anywhere except for these guys who go to the comic shops. And, like, I don't know, man. They're just sort of losing the battle of the stores almost. Like, you got to be in a goddamn store somewhere to, like, sell something, you know? And they just aren't. I mean, what do you think about that, Joe?
I mean,
I don't think
I think if you have enough presence and you can make it work,
yeah.
Thing, but you know, but I also feel I understand the appeal of a store. You know, I get the appeal of a store too. You know?
Right. Well, I'm talking about like the media, like the mass media kind of presence of comics, like. As far as like kids are like today and things like that, you know what I mean? It's like the comic books, like, you know, are, they're not anywhere where like kids go and shop and stuff. So like, unless you're a kid that's into comics and know where to go to get them. And I'm sure there are, and those kids are getting them, but it's like everybody else is just like, you know, out of luck, man. And then, and I think that's still, you know, they'll still survive, like the form, art form of comics. I think, yeah, absolutely. Cause you got web comics, you got, you know, graphic novels and stuff, you know, and all these, like, we're talking about like the kids comics and stuff, but it's like, you know, just like the comic book, you know, like the floppy DC, Marvel, Avengers, X-Men, stuff like what I was talking about before. It just seems like that stuff is doomed, man, unless something changes.
Well, definitely this, and what, year is gonna kick it on the balls pretty hard.
Yeah. Which I'm sure that's, you know, it's doing that to a lot of industries for sure. Mm-hmm. But
and I'm sure a lot more, you know, but I'm sure it's also this year is the birth of a lot more independent comics too.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you're seeing like that all over the internet for sure. You're just seeing more and more of this stuff.
Everything too, with a lot of entertainment, you're seeing like a lot more music coming out because a lot of people are just home, you know, and
have yeah.
to do it. And same thing with art. And okay. So I don't know, but I don't know what's going to happen with the like comic book industry, like as a whole, the market and everything. Man, every, you know, it's, I mean, you use your words, where people were saying for years for like, you know, decades.
And yeah. Well, I know. Because like when I did comics is like, you know, the so-called boom and also later the so-called bust. But all through the boom, they, you know, people were just gloom and dooming it all the time. You know, oh, it's going to die. And there's not going to be comics in 10 years and all that shit, you know. And I don't know. Even back then, I was always like, what are you talking about? Everything's going great. And then, you know, then the bus came. But even that wasn't nothing compared to, like, sort of where comics are right now, though. You know? I mean, they're so freaking, you know, I mean, just, like, the numbers and stuff. Like Diamond puts out, it's just, like yeah. Nobody has, like, any kind of good numbers. And, like, that's more what I guess I'm talking about. It seems like it's shrinking as a whole. And
do you think the independent market, like online, is shrinking, or do you think it's
growing? No, I think that's growing for sure. Which, I mean, maybe that's what Neil Adams means, is like, that's because, like, look at, you know, what's her name, like Lady Death and shit. Mm-hmm. And that guy's probably doing so much better than he ever did, you know. Or I don't know, who knows? He was pretty big, like he said.
He's picking and choosing, like, you know, he's getting to, I don't know, I guess he owned those companies though too, so it was kind of probably this, it's probably the same thing for him, you know what I'm saying?
So what did he do? So he owned Chaos or part of Chaos, and then he sold out?
Yeah, I think he was a part, like an owner of Chaos or part owner or
something. Part owner or something.
He looked it up one time, but I think, yeah, I think he had something to do with all that, dude.
I have a question about this guy, though. Mm-hmm. Number one, like, I got another question about Doom Barbarian. Does, like, Doom Barbarian have, like, some kind of necklace of teeth or something? And if he doesn't, why not? Because I want to draw it right now.
Put it on him. Who cares?
But then, like, my other question, and I need you to answer me this, is, like, mm-hmm. So what's that guy that does Chaos Comics? What's his name?
Polito?
Polito.
No, is that wrong? Oh, that's not his
name. Yeah, it is Brian Polito.
Brian Polito.
All right, we need to get a picture of Brian Polito up right now. A rocker picture.
Isn't he like 5'2", pure metal?
Actually, here, I got a different question. As long as we're... You know, I do hate the way freaking Google will not, like, give me a big picture of this dude.
Of who, Doom Barbarian?
No, of, like, Brian Polito.
Brian Polito. Well, none of the pictures are going to be big. I think he's really small.
Yeah, but it... Oh, God.
The short jokes, people.
Yeah. But we got like, okay, so here's another question I have for you. And I apologize to Brian Polito. So here's Brian Polito nowadays, right? This is him. Uh-huh. This cool rocker dude. And then this is him, like... Like what? Look, high school prom or something.
He looks like Evil Ernie.
I know he does.
He looks like Evil Ernie. Really? That is Evil Ernie. Right there.
Right there. Yeah, so you got hope, people.
Evil. It's your turn. Creepy looking Evil Ernie guy, and nowadays he kind of looks like a cult leader.
I shouldn't have said that. Yeah. But I just think, no, I mean, I can't help but to see, like, a similarity a little bit. Like, some kind of, like, a little bit of, hang on, I'm trying to type. I don't know. There's just something about this guy that kind of, like, you got Brian Polito here. Am I sharing still? Like, there he is, Brian Polito.
Yeah.
You know, he is shorter than Lady Death. Everybody should notice that.
There you go. But I mean, that. Point that out.
It's just like this picture kind of reminds me of this picture right here. I don't know why. You know what I mean? This is like, yeah, laid down. Like a little.
I see it.
Come on, like a little side by side action.
Yeah, like White Tiger.
I know.
He's just hugging a white tiger.
I think Polito could be the Tiger King of comics.
Put a little mullet on him. He needs a little party in the back.
Yeah.
Get him a stasher.
Yes.
He definitely needs a more flamboyant shirt. Get him out of that Metallica.
Yeah. Shirt. I mean, right there, just get rid of the babes and put Tigers back there. Yeah, it's totally like, it's Tiger King.
But, yeah, it's horrible.
Just stop. Why do you have to offend, like, everybody on the show? That's what I want to know. Yeah,
that's not why he does look like Evil Ernie.
Yeah, he definitely does look like Evil Ernie.
Proof that a lot of people, man, draw themselves into those books.
Yeah,
because they can put a mirror up and make the faces they need to make and pose out.
Yeah, I think it just kind of like, you know, like over time, you know, when you start to think of a face, you kind of, you know, like you said, you've looked in the mirror before, and so you just kind of naturally kind of do that, you know.
You're familiar with yours, you know.
Yeah. And then I think it's almost like what we were saying the other day, you know, when you draw comics as a kid, you know, you draw like yourself as a hero and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, everybody writes from their own perspective and stuff. So I think it's just natural. Now I've got my records all messed up. I had the perfect Doom Barbarian reference out. See, I feel like super fucking stressed right now, though, Jib. It's like I'm super worried you're gonna like look at this thing and go like, oh my god, what did you do to my character?
I'll tell you off camera. I'm nice.
That's what I don't want to hear, though.
You know what's funny is what I see so far. The face kind of reminds me of that sculpture.
Which sculpture?
That little sculpted out face that I did of him.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah, that was very cool. When you were gonna, Doom Barbarian toy. I love that actually.
Dog probably ate that thing.
Yeah, we got to get back on comics, man. We got to fucking quit with these stupid commissions and keep going back on comics, toys, animation, all that good stuff.
Yeah,
right.
I need to get back on it. I'm just taking a little breather. I need to get back on to doing some of this stuff, some of these ideas. It's just been nice to kind of not have to be locked into that thing at the moment. You know what I'm saying? As in,
yeah,
get all this done. I'm supposed to be doing this. You know, I want to finish the book.
Abe says another Dio size. Sorry. No.
That's right. Kind of looks like Dio a little bit when he had the hair. It's just a rainbow in the dark.
There you go. I know. Where the fuck is Randy? Somebody needs to go find Randy. And no, actually, I don't know where Frank is.
Yeah, Frank's been gone for
like,
two
Frank
days.
Frank has been gone for 2 days. And then, Frank like, number Frank two. I know. That's what I'm worried about. Has anybody checked the parking lot? Trying to make sure there's no windows being steamed up out there by Frank and somebody. But anyway, yeah, like there's no Frank, and then but we need Frank here because we need to go get Randy, get his butt in here. Put the call out, people. We need Randy to come watch the Arcast because I gotta tell him something. So Concern says this. Maybe this is an opportunity. In 1994, everyone said Jeff Bezos was insane. And his Amazon idea. Oh, I see. I thought there was something else we were going to say about it. People have gone back to vinyl music. I think people will go back to comics in hard copy. Well, that could, I hope so. And that is very true. You know, you get these collectible kind of niches and stuff that like survive. So that I really hope that is true.
I don't know why. And you kind of can see it happening a little bit, but I kind of feel like it's going to be the rise of the large magazine again, like the big anthology, the magazine anthology, you know,
those horror books and
all that stuff. You don't want that stuff to just take over, dude? Oh, I do.
Well, I'd love to see that, but it's like, I mean, I guess there are some, you know, like that, whatever we're buying there. I can't remember what they were calling it. Yeah, but I mean, what were the ones that are on the stand tomb? Yeah.
But I mean, who's doing barbarian ones? And you know, we need some of those out. We need to come out with some of those. And what else?
Well, what would be cool about that is, you know, you'd get like, I mean, you know, like everybody's doing these anthologies now. You could almost do kind of the same thing, you know, because you have a bunch of different artists putting out a book, you know. So I don't know.
The problem is doing it, because
yeah,
it's a lot of responsibility to put on one person, you know, it ends up
on somebody's shoulders.
And that's really what's going on, is everybody else is just waiting for somebody else to pick up that responsibility.
Right.
Don't lie. It's like, I'd love to jump on something like that.
Really.
I guess the work and the gamble may pay off for you.
So Abe says, can I make a Doom Barbarian sculpture or sketch? With a question mark. Sure, yeah. Frank is with the birds. This is Abe.
He's with a bird.
Oh, Lord.
He's with a bird. Maybe.
He's taking a roll in the feathers.
Oh, God.
Frank. Frank may be watching the other Artcasters. Are you fucking kidding me? The other Artcasters are going right now. What the hell is going on?
Well, hold on. That's it. Stream sniping.
I wonder what they're doing over there.
I'm going there right now.
Well, I'm going to beat you to it.
Yeah, you should go there and share the screen.
Where's the? I can't even remember what the hell. Until I find this fucking show. It's like on six different channels. Well, our show's live. Let's see. Would it be on Scott's channel, maybe?
I don't know. See, the problem is they do that. Yeah, they like bounce the show.
Yeah. So it's like hard to find.
Hide it from you. They like to hide it from you. I say you got to put it on top of the mountain. You put the beacon on top of the mountain, man.
Oh, here we go. So Artcasters 255, censorship and not safe for work content. Ooh, they're going to talk porn comics, man.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Oh, God.
What do you mean not safe for work?
Who's in there? Let's go see who's doing porn comics. This guy, Tim like Phillips,
that's right.
Scott Circland, a known pornographer.
Known pornographer. the sex dungeon.
Yeah,
that's right. Hold on, man. Watch this. They just look sad. Oh, I'm so sad. Let's see if we can find some porno on here, guys, and we can talk about it.
They're not having any fun at this show.
Come on, man.
This show's a total drag. At least, like, Scott's actually looking at the camera, and this one, he's not just drawing it, drawing away on his tablet or something.
Man, that man was... So they're talking about porno right now. That dude's really excited here. I shouldn't know that. I don't know who Tim Phillips is. I shouldn't be doing that.
I know. We shouldn't rip on this guy.
Yeah, I just blow up
on him. Does anybody know this guy?
I don't know.
This show's bringing me down. I gotta get out of here. Wait, I was going to see if Frank was in the chat. Let's go see if Frank's in the chat. Let's get back in there.
Hey, I thought I'd pop in and stream snipe. That's what you should put in there. Hey,
I don't recognize any of these people.
We're getting a few views right now, dude. Chill out.
Are we on Scott's channel? Oh, yeah, we are on Scott's channel.
Get in the chat in a second. Get in there. Hey, everybody, why don't you come over to the original art cat? No, I'm
yeah, anyway. I'd like to apologize to. I just hope Frank hasn't got the coronavirus and, you know, is on death's door. That'd be terrible. Abe says, he's drinking a tall glass of color Corona right now. Conan sized books. That would be cool.
Yes, it would be amazing.
Concerns giving us the 5-minute warning. He says, hey, everyone, I may have to drop off shortly. I have a quick, stupid question to ask. I'll take a post or two. I'm trying to break artist block in painting, and I'm afraid to ruin an expensive canvas. Look at this brutal. Canvases, so can I reasonably practice on paper and tablets, basically drawing pads? One tablet is drawing tablet by Canson. The other is marker pad by Ucreate. It says it's bleed resistant and acid free. So wait, what's he painting with then? You know that, I mean, I get that, you know what I mean? Especially like me, because I do like the, you know, paint on board, you know. Gessoed board, and then you got to cut the board and, you know, gesso it up. And you know, it is almost kind of like intimidating sometimes to like throw down something on there. And I kind of do that same thing. Like, that's why, like, I draw on paper and stuff sometimes, or I draw on my sketchbook. And then, you know, I just sell stuff out of that, you know, because it's like just anything to get yourself drawn. Cause like, yeah, that can be like really, like you said, just intimidating at times, you know. Yeah. What about you, Jib?
I mess up everything, so I just jump on it.
Yeah.
Worst case scenario, I just try to do it again.
Sometimes, and I've talked to Jib about this, or I think I have. Maybe it was somebody else, who knows? But like, I'll like try, like when I, especially when I feel that feeling, and I don't get it so much like in the beginning of an art piece, but sometimes like when I'm a couple days in on like a longer piece, because I'll feel like it's looking good. I don't want to ruin it now. You know what I mean? Even though it's not finished and it's never going to be anything unless I finish it. It's like, I'll get that sort of like stage fright of like, oh, I don't want to wreck it. And like, I'll do this thing where I'll just be like, you know, it's not going to ever be anything. And so just, you may as well just wreck it. You know what I mean? If it's just going to be, you know, something I slip in a drawer and nobody's ever going to see, then the hell with it, you know? And I'll kind of like, I'll just like attack it, like with all sorts of like fury and everything, and try to, and like almost like try to wreck it, try to be like overly loose and all that kind of stuff. And then what I've noticed is that like almost every time when I do that, it always works, you know what I mean? It always kind of like, it still comes out all right. So it's just that mental block, you know, and the way to beat that block is just put that freaking brush down on whatever you're doing and just go ahead, just like, you know, drawn or whatever, you know, which I know it's, I'm not trying to diminish it because it's very real and it's like tough, but you know, there you go. That's my advice anyway. So just go for it, dude. Yeah. Or draw on your sketchbook for a while if you want to. If you feel better in there, then, you know, the hell with that canvas. Just like throw it over in the corner and do something in the sketchbook. I think too, like being, or go ahead, sorry.
I guess it depends on how far in. Did he say how far, if he had started something already on it, or it's just a blank canvas? Because that's the whole thing too, like you were saying.
Yeah, I assumed he was talking about a blank. Mm-hmm. Oh, he's talking in oil colors. But, you know, you can paint in oil, like even on paper. I know that people say like, oh, oil, it'll eat the paper and all that bullshit like that. But that's just like, I mean, you know, I'm sure that like oil on a canvas, you know, a gesso canvas is going to be better. But like, you know, like up at the Denver Museum, you know, I remember going in there one time and on the wall they had a piece that was like painted in like the 1700s on paper that was oil, you know, the damn thing's still there and it looks fine, you know, I mean, like it'll last. It there's nothing, you know, that is going to happen there. So, and I have like little oil paintings that I've done in sketchbooks, and they're like in my sketchbooks just sitting around here and stuff. And so it's like, you can paint like on paper and stuff, you know, it's maybe it's not as good, but it's like, you know, it's nothing like inherently wrong with it or something, you know?
Yeah, I've definitely painted oils on paper, like in a little sketchbook. And then I actually did like a, what was it? Like a copy of, The Dark Kingdom by Frazetta.
Oh yeah,
piece of paper. Yeah, it was like one of the first YouTube videos I ever did, and I painted it on a big piece of paper.
Oh, that's cool. Kind of remember seeing that.
Maybe I don't know. I probably sent it to you. Like, hey, look at this, man. Tell me what you think. Please.
U-Trek. Yeah, U-Trek Artist Oils. So are you using, like, what are you using as a medium with that? Are you using, like, paint thinner, turpentine, you know, whatever, just out of curiosity, because I've been kind of struggling with that question since I got to do another oil painting here coming up. Yeah. Why do you want to put yourself through it?
I
Just kidding.
I just really want to, like, that those first couple of stages, like when I like put the paint on thin, and then I'm painting
yeah.
with the thinner. I love painting with the thinner. You know what I'm saying? I love the whole subtractive stuff when you're pulling out of it and the cloudiness and
yeah.
That's my favorite part. I get so into that, and then by the time I hit the finished product of what I've done, I'm like, I fucking ruined it.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, fuck. It's had so much going on. And then I started, got sick over the top of it, and I ruined it. I don't know, man. I love, definitely. Love the old.
I love the result. Yeah, like what you can do. And, you know, it's funny, like, when you say that, I agree with that. Like, you know, like where you can kind of pick stuff out and like almost paint with like the thinner and stuff. And I was thinking like about, you know, and hopefully, you know, Mike will never just watch this show or whatever, you know, but I was thinking about Mike Hoffman and his technique, you know, and he's kind of got, you know, he's got the Frazetta technique kind of thing. And that's something that he doesn't really do. You know, like that's one part of the technique that like where I see it in Frazetta's work that I don't think that he does it. Because like, you know, like in you know, like where he's got, you know, like he's on in the chains over the snake or something, and you have like all those little heads and shit in the mist in the back of the cavern or whatever. You know, you can just tell like he's just like he painted all that stuff in that exact way, like where he's just painting the thinner and just like picking the paint back off the canvas and stuff, you know. And Mike's very much like, you know, like strong underdrawing and then, you know, washing over. And I don't know. And that's not to bust on Mike Hoffman or, you know, whatever, but that I think that's one part of it that, you know. I don't know, that's not in there.
I guess that kind of takes him from, and that's one of the few things that, let's say it like this, that's one of the few things that makes him Mike Hoffman.
Yeah, makes him unique, sure.
Except Frazetta, you know, when a lot of people want to smash him with the Frank Frazetta title all the time, that's a good example of showing how he does differ, you know, and not even in a bad way.
Yeah, yeah.
Sure. See, I took your, you said, made it nice, Jeff. I'm never going to do that again.
Well, I mean, anybody can like take offense to anything, but you know, it's just an observation. It's not sort of like I'm trying to, you know, rag on him or anything, because I like Mike's stuff a lot.
Did you watch the Jeffrey Catherine Jones video from that one guy?
I didn't watch it last night. It was getting late, dude. I gotta go to bed at some point.
Used to stay up till like, what's going on all of a sudden, Jeff? Jeff used to be like, oh, I stayed up till, you know, a few more hours. Stayed up till about 7 or 8, you know, homeschool.
Seven or eight? I never did that.
Well, my time.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Well, I've been trying to like stop that freaking staying up till 6 a.m. kind of thing. So. Yeah, it does.
That'll have you talking the next day, like, yeah, man, you know.
That's right.
Like, he's like going to sleep every 5 seconds. Oh my God. Like, why are the lights in the house hurting me right now? The sun outside is hurting me. I am a vampire.
But that homeschool, it's funny. That's a lot of, like, you know. Just like you said, I mean, it's so hard to like freaking stay up with that and work all night like that, you know. Mm-hmm. For sure, man. Yeah.
Oh man! So, what's going on right now? Anybody selling anything? I know we got Kill Reva. I'm gonna throw Kill Reva's link in the chat. Oh, Lil Reva.
We need Randy in the house. We got an important announcement.
We're going to do it without Randy. Lil Reva. What did I just do? What did I put in there? No, that was wrong. Don't ever do that again.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know where Randy's at work. What's going on? I backed Kill Reaver. Oh, look. Frank left the other art cast and came here. We were spying on you, Frank. Just so
Frank's here. I've been killed. Yeah, where you been, Frank? That's what I want to know. Where you been, dude?
Like, getting laid, and then we realized that you were in the other art caster show.
Since
they haven't, they have topics about morals and stuff. We don't have morals here, Frank.
He's like watching bull shows, but he has like the sound off on ours.
I can listen to potty jokes, or I get a little education.
Yeah,
you know, that's easy for me. I'd be like potty jokes all day long.
What were they talking about over there? Like, were they talking about like porn comics or whatever?
Panda or something. I thought you know, don't sexual harassment in the workplace with your comic book or something. Wasn't that what was
going on? No.
Am I wrong?
No, it doesn't. But it says something like censorship and not safe for work content or whatever. That was like the title. What does
work content mean if it doesn't mean sexual harassment?
That's right. No, sexual harassment. It's not harassment. It's just like, you know.
But no, you know, not safe for work content. That means wear pants and underwear to work. Right?
What?
I don't understand what not for safe content, not safe for work content.
Well, you know, it's like any kind of nudity or anything. Something you don't want for you to be on your work computer and somebody walk in and see.
A work computer. Okay, man, I don't know. Like, yeah. Think about it, dude. It's like last job I had was a tattoo artist. My job was to offend people.
Oh, so Art, yeah, Salazar says the art caster was talking about not safe for work stuff, so I didn't watch it.
What did that mean? I'm still confused. Not safe for work. I'm confused. But yeah.
And then
everything's safe for work.
It's like, here's messaging Anna for a bit. Oh, we're just wondering where you were, Frank, because we need like to get Randy on the show because we gotta like tell him something and we needed to send you to go get him. So.
Oh man, yeah, that's it. You know what I'm gonna do? We should go over to the Facebook Artcast group and go see if anybody's been posting. I'm gonna go look in the and see before we go over there and make fools of ourselves. No. Let's see here. Oh, well, Wallace Destiny is always posting. He is true blue. He is the man.
He posts in there like every freaking day.
That's it.
No, you want me to share the screen? I want to go there.
I'm not doing it. I'm boycotting it today for that reason. Because the only thing there was a Wallace Destiny piece, which I mean, we should share, but people let me down. That's all I know. They're not, must not be working. They must be partying. Party on.
Yeah.
Not safe for work content, I guess. They're busy in those places.
Could be.
I would have a hard time, man. I'd be like, it's like, hold on. So you gave me a computer, you gave me the internet, and you're telling me I can't look at porno?
I don't think you've ever had the kind of job that doesn't have like a girly poster hanging on like a locker somewhere. So
yeah, of course. You see what I look like, right, Jeff?
Right.
You think they're gonna let me just work everywhere?
Yeah, not safe. Not safe for work is like your Doom Barbarian, basically. Not, okay. Yeah, not
safe for work. You should just have a picture of me giving a thumbs up.
Yeah,
it's like, hey, baby, you need to ride.
Think what Gib would do at this moment, kind of thing. It could be your guide.
That's it, dude. You got it. That's it. Not safe for work content. I don't know. I didn't know that was a thing.
Yeah.
What if your job's not safe? I'm not safe for the workplace, man. I'm telling you.
Yeah, I'd go along with that.
I knew some people that were definitely. I had a, okay, here we go. Here's a story. I used to work as a grease monkey. I used to change oil, you know, when I was younger.
Yeah.
And we had these bays where you laid on your back and you slid down under the car, you know? And then it had, above you, there was like this little trap that caught the oil. So, it, you know, when you took the
the oil plug off. It just didn't pour on top of you. It was like this little tray that slid, and you caught the oil in the tray, and you would take the filter and you'd put it on top of that tray and drain it. And so we were really busy, and they basically were like, what had happened is someone had a tall oil filter and it was sitting under there, sitting up, and they were like, if they drive through, it's going to catch it, you know, and it's going to drag that pan out and spill that oil. So like, hey man, slide under there and grab that and, you know, tip it over the oil filter so it doesn't catch. And so I did that. And right when I slid under and grabbed that oil filter, the owner waved the car out.
And oh my God.
I was holding onto the oil filter and it hooked the pan and started sliding the pan out. And literally there's like a lip there where you've got like a couple of feet, and where that pan is going to hit the edge of that bay and basically cut your hand off. And dude, yeah. I barely got my hand out in time. And then the oil pan spilled all over me.
Jeez.
Got out. Am I not safe for work content? I two hand shoved the boss man right in the chest and told him I was going to beat the living you know, out of him.
Yeah.
And, yeah. I got to go home for the day.
Oh my God. Well, they almost freaking like, you know, cut your hand off. I mean, that sounds like, yeah, a freaking lawsuit right there, man. Somebody, you go into the car and somebody drives the car out. I mean, that is ridiculous, dude. I could see why somebody would be pissed.
Yeah, dude, I was very mad. But yeah, I did jobs like God. That. So, yeah, I didn't never get no sweet office jobs.
Yeah.
Always like little things like that. Like, I'm doing this long enough until, you know, the big time calls me. Whatever that is. The big, you know, I guess I should try it out for the circus.
Yeah. So Autumn Rain says, damn, that's a freaking pointy stick you rocked there, Jeff. Holy shit. How do you get it so pointy? Are you talking about my pencil? I just sharpen it with a knife. So that's how I do it. Like, get it real nice and sharp.
He sharpens it to a shiv.
Yep. I don't know. Like, that's just, I don't know. To me, like, once I started sharpening like that, I couldn't go back to like pencil sharpeners. It just seems like it's not sharp when I do that. So,
knife or razor blade?
Well, it's a knife that has like razor blades. You know, you can switch them out. It's right here. It's not like a
pocket knife.
I was like,
this motherfucker's whittling these things with a pocket knife. Like, oh damn.
Yeah, see, it's like a folding utility knife. So it's like the drywall blades or something. Just put them in there. Then I just sharpen it, you know, like this. You know, without really doing it and getting it all over my thing.
Oh, you keep your finger right there while you do that?
I kind of do like this. I used to do it like this, but I don't know. If I do it like that, then I can really get them. Yeah, to like,
do not sharpen your pencils like Jeff, people.
You will the tiny little thing. That is true. And like those things are so sharp. Like sometimes I'll just barely brush my finger and it'll just make that sliver kind of cut in there. And yeah. They are definitely very, very sharp. You got to definitely be careful when you're messing around with that thing. So.
Yeah. You need to be 18 or older to sharpen your pencil like that.
Yeah, probably. Or like a kid that wants to be an artist and doesn't man. Give a shit.
You need to be a badass. That's what you're saying, Jeff.
So he says, wow, this right. must take some time. Cool. No, I mean, it doesn't, you know, I can sharpen them as fast as, like, you know, pencil sharper. Doesn't really take much time at all.
Not even to start them with the point? Or do you?
I mean, I guess, like, maybe the first time, you know, I do them, you know, it takes a minute to kind of get them there. But, you know, it's like when I'm drawing and they don't get worn down, like when this thing gets a little bit, like even right now, it's getting slightly dull. So I'll just kind of. Like, you know, give it like this kind of thing and turn it. And then, you know, thing comes back to life. So, but if it's not quite round, I'll do that kind of thing. Kind of really tip it up, make it into a little surgeon's needle.
So, you can stab somebody in the eye with it.
We need the art tip in here right now. Yeah, that's right. Just in case there's trouble in the studio, I'll just go to town.
If a bear breaks in or one of them damn mountain lions that keep eating people down there, Jeff.
Yeah.
They should move to Boulder, you know. That's where they were really getting the people.
Boulder.
That patchouli, man. They'd smell that patchouli and they'd be like, oh, shit, seasoning.
Yeah. That's very true. Yeah. Yeah, cougars are scary. I got to admit. It's like...
Ever been to a bar and ran into a cougar, Jeff? I'm just kidding.
Yeah. Yeah, really. Those kinds of cougars I'm into, but no, I'm not actually. I got a cougar. I got one cougar and she's married to me, so
a couple mountain lions, though.
Yeah. Let's see. I was going to read, the 9-volt Captain Courage Christmas comic holiday special is up for sale on Lulu.
Oh, y'all already got it up.
So there's like another one up for sale already? Are you kidding me? Wow. That's impressive, dude.
How do y'all, who's like,
I know.
Bang them out, like, bam, done. I just take what you
get. Yeah. Well, who's like formatting them, you know? I mean, maybe they just got like almost like a template at this point, but boy, they are like knocking those things out.
Yeah.
I mean, he's had like 3 comics come out in the last, I don't know.
Yeah, a couple of months, man. I mean, Jesus, that last one came out like, 2 months ago, maybe? A month ago? Now the next one's going to drop. They're on it, man. They need to start a little 9-volt comic company and just rock and roll.
I know.
Start trying to make some money with it.
They should, really. They should crowdfund them. Because even if they just crowdfunded for $500 or something, you know, you could divide that up amongst yourselves and everybody get like $100 or so for their comic. And you know, and then you guys could print up whatever you sell and send out, you know. So it'd be worth it. But that's just my 2 cents, you know.
We'll go ahead and say that was 4 cents, Jeff.
I know, like, yeah, like there's a lot of comic artists that don't want to make money. Like, money, are you crazy? You ever see that Burger King commercial where like the Burger King guy's trying to stick the money back in people's pockets? They're like ducking and diving. Like, no, what are you doing? that's like comic book guys right there. It's like, here, you lost $1,000. Here, let me put that back in your pocket.
All right, I don't need that.
Don't touch me.
That's how I am.
No, I want to pay you for your work. No, let me just give it to you. Here, let me pay you to take it, please.
Yeah. The easiest way to back, like, you know how it is. Once you get paid for it, you got to do it. The easiest way to back out of it is not being paid. Like, well, you know, we heard that one somewhere before. I think maybe earlier in this episode. I'm gonna post. You know what? Since we didn't get a lot on a Facebook group, I'm gonna say, hey guys, and if you are interested in having your work shown on the show, post at the Artcasters Facebook group, if you do not belong, ask to join, and one of the moderators there will let you join and post work, and we will show it on the show. We're not showing it tonight. There was like one piece or something. So I was like, nope, we'll save it for tomorrow. So if you get in there, join, post what you're doing. I'm sure y'all are working right now. I'm hoping y'all are. I'm not sitting around staring at the wall, listening to my dumbass talk. Go over there and join and post some work. I'm going to see what y'all are doing since I'm not drawing anymore.
Yeah.
Join.
The link for the Artcasters Facebook group is in the description underneath this video. If you go down there, it's in there somewhere.
Also right there in the chat.
The link for Gibran's Doom Barbarian comic.
Oh, that's in here. I'll throw that in there too.
Which I'm doing a piece of fan art right now for. And tomorrow when Jib puts his Indiegogo back up, I'll raffle this piece off.
Yeah.
To.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
I can say no too, Jeff. Oh, speaking of that, yes. Also, if you can get me to 1 million subscribers, Jeff will eat a Nightcrawler.
No.
And when he does it, I'm going to put Doom Barbarian.
Not going to do that.
See?
I know Gibran, and you'll go buy subscribers or something. Load my channel up.
Hell yeah.
So I'll eat the Nightcrawler, and then you'll get me kicked off of YouTube. I'll let you join. That's what Salazar says. He's a moderator at the
Caster's Facebook. Caster's
Facebook. Right, right.
Ain't
right.
In here.
Concern says bar cougars are a different breed. Yeah, right. That's true.
Night breed.
Yeah.
Love that.
That's kind of bad. Like you ever like? Well. Anyway, well, if people want to give money, oh, there you go. Well, it was like a bar cougar story that I thought better of telling. Gordon Mallet this year. Hey, dude. You guys invisibly got me into painting comics. Holy shit. Are you kidding?
Well, Gordon, do you post at the Artcasters Facebook stream? Because we'd love to see the work.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah. If you want to share your stuff, head in there, man. And thank you for saying that. I don't know. Which we had to do with it, or I had to do with it for sure.
It was definitely Jeff.
well, I left you out because I thought, well, maybe Jeff wants to take credit for that, so I'll let him do that.
It's Jeff. But that's okay. Well, what's this? If you get Anna to at least 100, Frank will eat a bug. He'll eat a bug for her, is what he's saying right there. Jeff, I'll never eat a bug for you. So now you know, but I'm glad you'll eat a Nightcrawler for me.
So Anna, let me, if you get Anna to 100, I'll eat a bug.
All
right.
He's trying, yeah. Jeff's thinking of how he can get, but see, here's the thing is, I want to set the rules to the bug.
Yeah.
I don't want this bug cooked in a brownie. I want this bug alive and from the pet store or wherever we're getting this bug from or whatever we eat.
Like you pet store.
Cicada, Frank, let's get a. I want you to eat a big ass cicada, like buzzing. I want you to hold it. I want it flapping in your hand right before you eat it. You gotta like bite into it and eat the juicy nougat.
Oh my god. Yeah, I'd like to see that. No, actually, I don't want to see that.
Come on.
Actually, you know what I didn't want to see? Well, I'm sure didn't want to do the search, and I did, and now I've seen it. Whoa, oh, my God.
Look at that. I want you to eat that, Frank. If I get to we can get this show to 1 million subs. Frank will eat that grub.
What kind of fucking psycho picks that up? I'd be like, I would be scared that thing would attach to my hand or something, man. Holy shit.
Why the hell suck the head?
Oh my god. That's not right.
Come on, man.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it looks delicious.
I caught a okay. Hang on, let me where is my I gotta get this off the screen. Okay.
That thing was huge. What kind of freaking grub is that?
That was so nasty. Maybe that should be the thumbnail. Okay, we're going on what's it called? So, like, wild Anna's cat. Gonna eat this thing. Like, if Anna eats this thing, I guess I'll push for her to get 100 subs. I'll push.
You better give her at least 120.
I'll push for her. Yeah, we'll push her like we pushed Randy over the finish line here. Because that is
Jesus.
Fucking nasty, dude. That is disgusting.
You got to eat that man. Like a knife and a fork. That's like a meal for bugs, dude.
Concern says, oh my God, yeah. Yeah, you're like, oh yeah, that's, I don't even want to envision it. She's at 75 right now. That's what Concern says. And he's concerned about it. I would be. And Salazar said he caught a grasshopper the other day and it's in a freezer. We didn't let him back out. It's probably, that's probably doing too good in there.
I believe if you freeze a fly, let a fly out and let it defrost it all, and it can still live.
I think that's probably true. Yeah.
Like, has such simple wiring or whatever you want to say.
Wiring. Yeah. You know
my technology, Jeff? That was.
Well, I was just,
Randy's making it in tonight, man. And I think it's time. I think.
Oh, man. Would you just drop it? Okay.
Yeah, I think we should drop it like it's hot, guys.
Well, wait, you know what? I totally lost the damn link. I'm going to have to go back to Facebook to get it with all our shenanigans.
That's all right.
All right, here it is. Jibs. Hang on, wait a minute.
That's right.
Come on, Facebook.
We're talking about Lil Reba yesterday, and Lil Reba tonight is dropping his first single right here on the ArtCast. You're seeing it here first, people. Seeing it here.
Wait up. Hold on. I got to like turn the cam sound on my damn window. Just hang on.
You're ruining it.
Share screen. Okay. Share audio. Yeah.
This is how you drop.
Dear God. I know. I'm so sorry.
Yeah. No, I'm sorry.
There it is.
Boom. Lil Reva.
Lil Reva. Lil Reva. Lil Reba.
Get out my way when I'm swinging my axe, cause I'll be chopping off your head when my broadsword attacks. We getting drunk on weed, we getting high on weed, we doing what we please, and yeah, we real OGs. Watch out for Lil Reba when you on the attack, cause stepping up to hit you, you ain't stepping back. And just so you know, when the king's away, that Lil Reba gonna make sure that you pay.
There it is.
That's right, Lil Reva.
Coming everybody.
At you from the streets.
Everybody's left the show.
Yeah, everybody leave.
No, that was really good, dude. You do sound like two different people in that. Like, there's like you come in later and it's like almost like the chorus, or I don't know what you'd call that, like the background type singers or something. Mm-hmm. And you sound different, you know, you sound like deeper or something. That's funny as hell.
All right. And don't forget, guys, Kill Reaver is still live on Indiegogo. So go check it out. And if you haven't bought your copy yet, jump on over there and get one. Lil Reaver. Yeah, Randy missed it. That's all right. We were waiting, man. We were waiting for him.
But and,
he's probably doing a big tribal tattoo right now, a tribal dragon on somebody's.
He probably is.
But
on what? Right on her butt. Mm-hmm. He's yeah.
You know,
got some chick's big fat ass in his face while his wife is piercing her front end.
There you go.
The glorious or the glamorous life of tattooing, right?
All I gotta say is I love the cover. My favorite part's the cover, man.
Let me refresh it. Well, actually, there we go. Sorry. It started up again. Mike Whitcomb liked it, though.
That cover, bro. I worked on that cover. I found a way to make it look as much like an old school No Limit record.
Yeah.
Bam, Lil Reva.
Autumn Rain says, is it on vinyl?
We're going to try to get them on vinyl next year. They're going to drop on CD this year. We're going to be selling out of the trunk of my car.
Yeah.
Get you one now.
EJB's got it stuck in his head.
You know, that's my Lil Reva pouring it out for the homies.
Yeah.
Hope Randy likes that, man. Randy's going to be totally offended, dude. Totally offended.
Yeah, he's never going to come back on the show after that.
On the show.
We got to keep. we got to keep it on the down low so that it kind of what he does. What if he'll watch the show like tomorrow? Though he might watch it. Who knows?
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna end up sending it to him. I plan on.
Oh. Sending
it. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Funny white boy raps. Yeah, why not? apparently in 2020 I've decided to just not give a damn anymore.
Yeah. You know what it kind of reminded me of though is that Jim Lujan, like his animation. You know what I mean? Because he does a lot of, you know, rap and like he does his own music. And like I could totally see like, you know, like his animation, like going along with that and it just looking really good. So next time you need to animate it, that's what I'm telling you.
Dude, man, it took so long just to do that little bit, you know? Like, wow. And I ended up like jacking the beat and stuff. So I didn't come up with that. I wish I did. I even put it on the record thing. It's like beat stolen by, and I put the dude, which is,
yeah.
Guy's name. I don't remember it.
Right. We'll see if I get copyright stuff. Maybe I won't. If he's not like huge, I might, you know, might not. Who knows? I mean, if it's just like a beat, though, don't they already like steal the beats and rap songs anyway? I thought that was like a thing they did. Don't they like sample or something like that?
Yeah, they sample, but I don't think that was like sampled or anything. It might be, but I just felt like,
yeah,
trying to do something. It was just getting rough. And I was like, man, I'm just gonna snag this. It sounds cool. And it was a long time. Because, you know, I don't rap, man. I didn't know how to do that.
It
took a little bit.
It sounded pretty rap-like. Yeah, I don't know.
Pretty funny.
Yeah.
I think the only other time I've ever tried to rap was like that one birthday song for Frank. I kind of did two different versions. One was like a rap version, and then did the piano version that was like sounded like it was like the end of a movie.
I love that. Yeah.
Yeah. So, you know. I had to reach over and see if the piano was on.
Frank's birthday song was hilarious. I wonder, did I load that up? Or I guess I didn't load that. That was just on YouTube somewhere.
Yeah, that was on my page.
We got Mike Whitcomb's birthday song. That's the one that got you
not on my page.
Taken down. You took that one off?
Page. Yeah, they kicked that one off, dude.
Oh, they kicked it off. That's right. Which is crazy because, like, on that one, I actually put the thumbnail up. And they never kicked. They never did anything about that one. What the hell? Let's give a old Mike Whitcomb another birthday wish.
All he wants to do is drive a Zircon up, maybe pay for two, and put it on Indiegogo just for you, and maybe make a dollar or two, because it's your birthday, Jeff. And I hope it was the best. Your birthday, Jeff. I hope it was the best.
I forgot that was my birthday song.
That was your birthday song.
I don't know.
You birthday songs nowadays, man.
I know.
Huh?
What do we do for Jim's birthday, for God's sake? None of us can sing. My God, when is your birthday, Jim?
Just forget mine exists.
I'm going to have to go on to Facebook and find this out. Frank, go to Facebook before Jim can get there. Find out what his birthday is before he deletes it. Hurry! Yeah. Mike Whitcomb says, "Fuck you, YouTube." that was the funniest one though. Mike's with the strippers, man. Right. I was crying with that one.
I'm trying to see here.
And that was the first appearance of the eagle too, which I still haven't put on. I think so. Didn't we have the eagle fly by in the beginning of that one?
4th of July was the first
appearance. Oh, that's right.
Steals the chicken off the guitar amp. Yeah, when you get that damn eagle back in some stuff, I love that damn eagle.
Yeah, that eagle's hilarious.
Give me just a second here, dude. I'm gonna cut this down, but of course, right.
I don't know why I deleted half those. I mean, those were like so good. I don't know. Well, maybe because I was trying to get the damn intro in here. That makes sense. Because I remember the intro was like really hard to fucking upload. I had to take me like 3 times to upload, and I thought it was because I had no room left or something. Because the intro is like long compared to those, so anyway.
I wonder. I can't play things with Twitter to have a sound, though, huh? It has to come off of yours to have good sound.
Oh, well, yeah, it's better offline, but it's better if I upload it. Like, I played that off YouTube. Could you guys hear that okay?
Yeah, I heard it just fine.
So Mike says, like, I could see Gib being the new face of his mumble rap era.
Mumble rap, yeah.
Mumble rap.
That's like, I don't know, what was it, like, late 90s, early, I guess early millennium, really. Southern rap was real. You know?
Oh, really? Yeah.
Rap like that. I like that.
That's cool.
See, here in Texas, we have something called Chopped and Screwed, where we like slow it down and it's like, hey, 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 oh, it's like really deep and it's like scary sounding.
And it's rap?
Yeah, it's rap.
Mm, interesting. I don't know why we all need rap. Why is everybody in? Yeah, I don't know. I'm good with no rap. Let's just get rid of it. Let's bring back disco or something. I mean, yeah. Anyway, you know what? It's like 12 o'clock. Should we blow out on everybody? I'm sorry about that.
Okay, hold on. Let me see if this works real quick, though.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
I hate my life, people. I don't care.
Wait, what are you going to play?
I'm going to play the Mike. I'm going to try to play the Mike's birthday song.
Oh, okay. You found it somewhere? Yeah. Well, I probably have it on my computer. I could have done that.
Oh, well.
I thought you wanted me to find it uploaded somewhere.
Oh, it ain't got uploaded anywhere.
Well, it's still on our video, though, because they didn't take my video down on my channel. You know what I mean? Like the Rcast that it was in, but it's just
because it's buried into a live stream.
That's yeah.
Was as I had it.
But isn't that weird though? Like they deleted off yours, but then it's in one of mine. Mm-hmm. And even though like the midgets were buried in like a 2-hour live stream, they found that.
Yeah.
But then they don't go and they don't find like, you know, it doesn't make sense. YouTube makes no sense.
There's nothing wrong with the stupid video. I mean, it's basically a girl.
Oh, there's a lot wrong with it. It's pretty much what's wrong with America. Yeah.
You ain't done a show.
Oh yeah, I'll do it. Is that what you said? I didn't hear you. I was talking over you. God damn it! I got like double screen shared. So if you have to pour it out, I'm one of them. Hide it. Oh God!
The eagle every time.
That was so much fun.
And now I can't back out of this. Don't be playing with me.
Did we make that one together, or was that? Because I remember we did the 4th of July one together, like really late at night, like on Skype. But then I don't remember if we.
This one, I think what happened, how this one got put together was I did this, obviously did the song, and then we were talking, and you told me, I need this.
That's right.
Stuff up for you and sent it to you.
Right.
To go to bed, and you built it.
That's right. I animated it. You found it, all the stuff. And I was like, I need 2 strippers. I need. And then, yeah, that's right. That's why I put the eagle at the end.
I got a little smoky on there. The girl smoking that cigarette while she's wiggling.
Oh, yeah. That was so funny.
You like make her wiggle like that. You just take 2 pictures, flip one, and then you make it switch. Boom.
arm, and she looks like she's wiggling.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, man. You know.
Yeah.
And man, you know what? I can't help it, dude. Since we're here,
it's like the Ed Sullivan show suddenly.
Get them all tonight. I get them all, but you're getting some. All right. you know what I did? My dumbass. Guess what I didn't do?
Share what? Sound. Oh, Lord have mercy.
Stop sharing. Oh, I hate that. Share the sound. Share the sound every time.
Why do they? That is the dumbest part, like, feature of Streamloads, is that share the sound. It's like, obviously, if you were trying to share your screen, you're trying to share it.
Yeah, all right.
What the hell?
Go ahead and share me one more time, please.
Sorry. Okay. All right, I was trying to draw two lines, but I'm back on it.
I'm never gonna ever. Did I not? I hit it this time. What the fuck?
I don't hear anything. Is it on your computer?
Yeah, it's not playing any noise at all.
Oh, that's weird. Oh, the Frank birthday. Yeah, the one that started it all.
Yeah, but I can't get it to work.
And made Frank a fucking household name in the 100 Days of Comics world. It sucks.
Yeah.
We could sing it. Happy birthday to Frank. Happy birthday to Frank and Anna.
I'm gonna do all that, huh?
Oh Lord, we're getting it live.
I don't remember it. Damn.
I know, I don't remember.
Never mind.
Oh God. You should sing us out of every show. Well, actually, maybe not.
Yeah, I'll try.
I feel like we're on the end of Saturday Night Live right here. Oh, there we go. Now you're getting it.
No, it sounds funny, but I just can't stand the pain. Girl, I'm leaving you tomorrow. No, girl, I've done you all I can. Well, I think I stole tomorrow. I'm easy like Sunday morning. I'm easy like Sunday morning. I'll fuck that up later, guys.
I loved it. That was great. We're out. See you guys later.